No, Max. Maxie, Richie. Don't do it.
Richie,
Maxie,
wake up.
Listen, it's not up
Richie,
to me, Max.
You're having a bad dream.
I can't help you. Please,
Richie.
Max. No.
Richie, wake up. Wake up. Oh, dear me. What on earth is...
Gee, horrible nightmare, that.
Come on, love.
Really frightening stuff.
Come on, there you go. It's okay.
Stress. That was awful. What time is it, love?
It's just after 7.
Well, I might as well get up then.
Okay. Gee, what on earth were you dreaming about? You were screaming something about an axe.
An axe? Oh, no. It was Max. Max Walker. He's still following me around everywhere trying to get his job back on the commentary team. 2 years it's been now. Doesn't matter where we are, the Gabba, the Wacka, the MCG, there he is, hassling me. Now I've started having nightmares about him. I dreamt he had me bailed up in the commentary box. He was like a madman, swinging this huge cricket bat around. He's saying, put me back on the team, you bastard.
Oh, Richie, please.
Sorry, love. Anyhow, he says, give me my fucking job back or I'll take your fucking head off.
Gee, that's not very nice.
Strength. He's going to be there again today, you know, at the SCG. On top of that, I got name pronunciation lessons with the commentary team for this Pakistan game today.
What, they're still getting them wrong?
Hopeless. All of them. Bill's the worst.
Oh, well, never mind, love. I'll go and fix you some brekkie. You have a shower.
Thanks, Dale. I'll be down there in the kitchen in just a few moments. Oops. Go for duck. Checks. Check 1, 2, 2. Did you get the check? Did you get the check? Check 1, 2. Welcome back. Welcome back to the SCG. Oh, what a catch! What a catch! Marvellous effort, that. Really a super effort. 2 for 22. Super effort, that.
Welcome back to the kitchen, love.
Thanks, Pet. Marvellous to be with you in the kitchen for the first time today.
There you go. Careful. Plate's hot.
Yeah, thanks. How's the toast?
Nearly ready.
Oh, what a catch! What a catch!
Oh, careful, Rich. Don't want to overdo it. Got a long day ahead of you.
That's okay, love. I've been warming up in the shower.
Here's your newspaper.
Oh, great.
Now, what jacket do you want to wear? The cream, the bone, the off-white, the white, the ivory, or the beige?
Yep. Sounds great, love. Thanks.
What's so funny, love?
Just something I wrote in my column here. Super piece of writing, that. Really funny stuff.
Oh, that's good. I just heard on the radio there might be a bit of rain later on.
Oh, really? Oh, what a bugger. Oh, well, make sure you throw the deck of cards in for me, will you, love?
Okay. Now, listen, I'll just go and iron your jacket for you.
All right. The cream one, the bone, the off-white, the white, the ivory, or the beige, love?
Yes, I know, love.
Super cup of that. As a matter of fact, love, marvellous breakfast all round.
Oh, thanks, dear.
There's my cab. Okay, love, I'm off now. Have a nice day. Mwah. Super kiss, that.
Oh, Richie.
Okay, Dal. I'll be back here at the flat in just a few hours, and I'll look forward to your company then.
All right, love. Bye.
G'day, mate.
Good morning.
So you're going to the cricket ground, eh?
Yeah, thanks.
Gee, I tell you what, mate, you'll be bloody lucky to get a seat out there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's all I've been doing all bloody days, taking people out of the bloody cricket ground.
Well, I think I'll be right for a seat.
Well, I hope so, mate.
Rickard, eh? The other car?
You know, it's one fucking game I just can't fucking get into the cricket. It's so bloody slow, you know what I mean? It's so fucking boring for me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I tried watching it a couple of times at home on the TV, you know, with that bloody guy, Richie Ben Arthur, or whatever his fucking name is. You know, the guy on the Wide World of Sports.
Yes?
But, no, mate, you know, I just can't get into it, you know what I mean?
Well, no, I don't. I happen to love the game.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, I do, very much.
Oh, well, there you go. That's good, mate.
Yes, it is. Very good. Now, if you don't mind, I've got a very important article to read again in the paper.
Yeah, OK, mate. No worries, mate.
Right. Do you think we might be able to turn that down a bit, please?
Okay, mate, that's $15.90.
Right, there's 16. Keep the change.
Oh, gee, thanks, mate. Hey, mate, listen, I've been trying to work out where I know your face from. Haven't I seen you on the bloody TV somewhere?
Well, yeah, as a matter of fact, you might have.
I thought so. Hey, geez, aren't you that bloke who does the bloody weightlifting and the motorbikes? Bloody Dallas-like. You're Dallas-like.
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, I thought so.
Dickhead.
G'day, Richie.
Yeah, g'day, mate.
Hello, Richie.
Hi, how you going?
Oh, not bad, Richie.
Well, yes, that's what I reckon. Oh, look, is that Richie Benno? Oh, yes, I think it is. Excuse me, aren't you Richie Benno?
From the body of the same name. How are you, girls?
Oh, good, thanks. Yes, good, thanks. We love you on TV.
Ah, thanks a lot. So do I.
G'day, Richie.
G'day, boys. How you going?
Oh, pretty good.
Hey, Richie. How about an autograph?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Who will I make it out to? Just the dear Richie?
Ah, piss off, you cheeky little bastards.
Oh, what a cat. What a cat.
Go on, piss off.
Richie.
Oh, shit, bloody Max.
Hey, Reggie. Wait a sec. Hey, Reg.
Yeah, g'day, Max.
Yeah, g'day, Reg. Look, I was just wondering if you'd heard anything about me getting my job back on the commentary team.
No, Max, I haven't. Like I've been telling you all along, mate, it's not up to me.
Yeah, I know, Reg, but they might listen to you if you put in a good word for me, you know?
Yeah, well, Max, I have been putting in a good word for you. I'm a big fan of yours, you know that. I don't think they should have given you the flick in the first place.
Yeah, I know. That's great, Rich. I really appreciate it, mate. I was just wondering if you could hassle him again for me, you know, maybe convince him to give me a quick shot today. Yeah, you know, maybe just let me call about 15 minutes of the game or something to show him I've still got what it takes.
Max, I'll do my best. I promise you, I'll do my very best.
Oh, gee, thanks, Richie. I really appreciate it, mate.
Yeah, okay, Max.
You're a good pal, Rich.
Security?
Yes, Mr. Benno.
If Max Walker comes within 10 feet of this fucking door, shoot him, okay?
Whatever you say, Mr. Benno.
Morning, fellas.
Yes, very good morning.
Good morning, Richie.
Okay, well now we've got to get straight into the name pronunciation rundown for this Pakistan team today. Let's do a quick roll call first. Tony.
Yeah.
Bill. Bill. Anyone seen Bill?
Oh, no, well, I certainly haven't.
Right. That's it. Okay, Ian.
Yes, I'm here, Rich.
Ian's brother Greg.
Yes, he's here too.
Morning, Richie. Morning, all. Sorry I'm a bit late.
Again? Look, I've had just about enough of this, Bill. If you're not interested enough to turn up on time, there are plenty of people around who are, mate. I don't need to remind you how interested Max Walker is in getting back on the team.
No, you certainly fucking do not. That's why I'm late. Bloody Max's a silly bastard. He had me bailed up downstairs. He's off the fucking wall, Richie. He has been ever since he got the arse.
My bloody
hassling everyone. Yes,
the moment is really difficult to handle.
You're bloody right, bro. Okay, settle down. Look, I've asked security just this morning to try and keep him away. Apart from that, I don't know what else I can do.
Well, for starters, you can have the bastard barred from this part of the broadcast area.
I'm sorry, what was that, Tony?
I said, for starters, you can have the bastard barred from this part of the broadcast area.
Ah, no, I heard you, mate. I'm sorry. I just wanted to hear you say it again.
Got him,
yeah, Richie, that was right. Richie, right there. That was
very good. Okay. Come on. Can we get back to this roll call, please? David?
Present.
Michael?
I'm cool, man.
Richie? Right, that's me. Okay, all present and correct. All right, now, the pronunciation of the Pakistan players' names. It's been fucking atrocious all season. And today, we are going to get it right. Now, I'm going to run through this team from top to bottom, and I'm going to say the names, and then I want you all to repeat them together nice and loud and nice and clear, okay?
Yes, okay, Richie.
All right, then. Javed Jamait for me and Dad.
Javed Jamait for me and Dad.
Nice and loud now. Wasim Ranamad Ruta.
Wasim Ranamad Ruta.
What do you mean, was he?
What do you mean, was he?
Come on, Bill, concentrate right, now. Asif he'd give a sheed.
Asif he'd give a sheed.
I'd say he'd give a sheed.
I'd say he'd give a sheed.
That's good. That's pretty good. Amir Sahail.
Hail, Richie. Hail the great man. Hail.
No, Bill, that's his name, you dickhead.
Sorry.
Concentrate now.
Fair suck of the Elspeth Gordon. Oh, gee, come on. It's not my bloody fault. These bloody Pakistani names are just ridiculous. Some of them sound like questions. Some of them sound like swear words. They're just too bloody hard to pronounce.
Yeah, they're bloody
odd. We're going to have to agree on a sensible form of these fellas' names at the start of the season.
Yeah, Bill's right.
Use a bloody nickname if you have to. But I'm telling you what, it's just ridiculous expecting a man to analyse the game and commentate as well as analyse three quarters of the alphabet and try and get a bloody name out of it.
Yep.
It's just ludicrous.
It's bloody true, Bolt. What do you fellas think?
Yeah, okay, fellas. Look, I'll have a yarn with the ACB about it. But for the moment, can we get on with the job at hand, please?
Yeah, okay.
All right, now listen carefully. I keep my teeth in a jar beside the bed.
I keep my teeth in a jar beside the bed.
Never been behind bars.
Never been behind bars.
Was he a crim?
Ramesh Raja.
Give him Malik. Got my mushtak up his ass.
That's right.
Yeah, well, I think
that's right.
All right, fellas, can I have your attention, please? Fellas!
Hey, be cool, man.
All right, now, I just want to go over the commentary schedule for today's game.
Oh, cool, man.
Okay, now, we're going to kick it off with the Chapel Brothers today.
You fucking what?
Oh, come on, Richie, you can't be serious. We always go first. The fans love it.
No,
bit of colour, bit of life, plenty of experience. That's what's needed in these one-day matches. Well, we must get off to a good start or lay the foundation for the rest of the team to build on as the game progresses.
Quite finished, are you, Bill?
No, I'm not, Richie. I think it's absolute silliness to abandon what's been a winning formula like Tony and myself. It's vitally important in these limited overs games to have an experienced opening combination.
Bill, shut the fuck up. We're going with the Chapels, and if you don't like it, then piss off, and I'll get Buddy Max or someone else to do your job.
Good luck, Ian, Greg. Have a good call, fellas.
Yeah, good luck, fellas.
Thanks very much, Bill.
Excuse me, Richie. I'm sorry to barge in like this, mate.
Max,
I just thought that while all you fellas were together here, I might be able to say a few words on my own behalf to see if I can...
I'm sorry, Mr. Benner. I just turned my back for a bloody second. Bang, he was past me in a flash. I called for him to stop, but he wouldn't have my bloody gun jam.
Yeah. Okay, I'm security, sorry. Okay.
Anyhow, fellas, listen, now that I'm here, I was happy you might consider giving me another go.
Max, tell your fucking story walking, pal. Security, get him out of here.
Oh, no, Richie, please.
No, you've gone too far this time. Max, on your bike.
Oh, jeez, Rich, I'm sorry.
Come on,
fellas,
come
I'm sorry.
Come on now.
No, look, I won't do it again, I promise. Richie!
Your bloke's a madman. Anyway, come on, fellas, let's get back to business. Oh, gee.
Richie, darling, make up now, sweetie.
Yeah, okay, Kevin. Now, listen, fellas, while I'm having my makeup put on, I want you all to have a few minutes warming up, okay? Try and G each other up a bit. Bill and Tony, you work on the aggro thing, and Ian, you work with your brother. Guide him. Wind him up. Get him excited.
Okay, Richie, darling, sit still now for Auntie Kevin while he makes it look beautiful.
Yeah, righto, Kevin. Ah, gee, careful, you just got me in the face with your bangle.
Sorry, love. Lucky it wasn't a ring.
Hey, Kevin, tell me, do you like cricket at all? I mean, you spend so much time around the game, day after day. Do you actually enjoy it?
Well, sort of, Pet. I don't mind getting caught behind now and then.
Hey?
As long as I'm batting from the Paddington end, though.
Ah, all right,
used to be quite a handy tail-ender in my time.
Yeah, okay, sorry I asked, Kevin,
Oh, sorry, love. All righty, there you go, darling. How does that look?
Ah, struth, Kevin, what have you done?
What?
Oh, I look like bloody Kirtley Ambrose.
Oh, you wish. What's the problem, sweetie?
Oh, it's so dark. What shade have you used?
It's dark tan, like we always use, darling. It's just a new brand. Bondi Bronze, I think it is. I think it looks gorgeous on you anyway, sweetie. The silver hair, the powder blue shirt, the cream jacket. It's a story, lovey.
Yeah. You really think so?
Yes, darling. Trust your Auntie Kevin. Now, let me put some spray on that hair.
Okay. Just a bit more over here.
There we go. How's that?
Not out. No, sorry, Kevin. That's fine. That's fine, thanks.
Voila, Monsieur Benno. You look gorgeous, darling.
Yeah. Yeah, thanks, Kevin.
All right, my love. Au revoir. Come on now, Billy boy. Let Auntie Kevin get to work on that nose of yours, Pet. Probably take us a few hours.
Control room to Richie. Control room to Richie. Are you there, Rich?
Yeah, Jeff, I can hear you, mate. Good morning.
Morning, mate. Listen, we've got about 15 minutes to go before we're on air and I need to go over a couple of things with you. Can I come down now?
Yeah, sure. Come straight down. I'll see you in a sec.
Be right there.
Excuse me, Richie. Could you keep an eye on Wendy Jr. for me while I go and have my makeup put on?
Bill, I haven't got time to look after your bloody pigeon. I've got this commentary schedule to go through and some notes to make.
Oh, please, Richie, I'll only be a second. I don't trust any of the others to look after her. They don't like Wendy Jr.
Okay, Bill, put it down here on the desk. Not near my notes.
Right. Gee, sorry, Richie. Wendy Jr., you naughty girl.
Yeah, look at this.
Say you're sorry to Richie. She said she's sorry, Rich.
Yeah, okay, Bill. Go on, off you go. Hurry up.
Thanks, Rich. I won't be a minute.
Wendy, come on. Come on, Wendy Jr. Come on. Come to Uncle Richie. There you are. Come on. There you go. Go on.
Hey, Rich, you're right to go?
Yeah, Jeff, come in, mate. How's it going?
Yeah, good, thanks, mate. Good. Morning, fellas.
Morning, Jeff.
All right now, Rich, this is the running sheet for today, mate.
Right.
So, listen, if it rains later on, we'll have to fill in with the classic commentaries of some of the other competitions.
Right, eh?
We've got the classic commentaries down to the final 500, so you can show a few of them.
Yep, good.
Crap on about the prizes, that'll fill in another half an hour.
That's right, yeah, good.
And then, if it's still raining, we've got highlights from Australia v West Indies from the other night.
Perfect. Sounds great, Jeff.
All right, mate, we'll have a good one.
Thanks, mate.
So we might get some cards, you know.
Yeah, it does.
All right, mate, listen, I'm going back up to the control room. I'll talk to you from there.
Great, Jeff. See you later on, mate. All right, then, listen up now, fellas. Fellas! Fellas!
Uncool, man.
Okay, now, we're on air in just about 10 minutes. So, Tony, I think you better get down to the centre for your pitch report.
Yes, okay, Rich.
And you know they're predicting rain later on.
Yes, I heard the forecast. Did you bring the cards?
Got them right here.
Oh, good.
Now, off you go, and Ian, you better get going too. Get yourself ready for the toss of the coin.
Yes, okay, Rich.
Now, the rest of you fellas, just keep practicing the Pakistani names, going over them in your mind, make sure you know them. And Greg, you make sure you're warmed up because you're first in the commentary box with your brother.
Yes, okay, Richie.
Come on, let me hear a bit. Show me what you can do.
Well, Australia, very keen to win here. Alan Border, Australian captain, needs to put together a good score here today.
That's good. That's pretty good. I like the way you're cutting off the start of each word there. That's nice. And the same upward inflection on everything is good, too. You'll be annoying the shit out of the viewers in no time. Yeah, come on, let me hear a bit more.
Well, Australian batsmen right on top here in this match. Just need to make sure they don't panic.
That's good.
Just need to pick their shots. And
that's good. That's very good. We'll be right back.
Welcome to the Sydney Cricket Ground for this preliminary match in the Benson and Hedges World Series Cup between Australia and Pakistan. Both teams on 2 points coming into today's game, and I'm sure they'd both be equally keen to pick up another two here too. Now, the two teams for today's match, firstly Australia, and just the two changes there to the side that played the other night at the MCG. Mervyn Hughes comes in for the injured Mike Whitney. Whitney's still being troubled by that groin of his. And Greg Matthews also comes into the side. The ACB apparently think he's worth another 10,000 bums on seats here at the SCG. They regard him as a bit of a loose cannon. And for Pakistan, Asifi Givashid and Adsaeed Givashid come into the side, replacing Ahmedi Minagaybar and Jiwadawaka. Well, it's nice and bright and sunny here at the SCG right at this moment. There's some talk of rain, possibly a bit later on. And to find out more about that and the condition of the strip, let's go down now to Tony Gregg for his pitch report.
Yes, thank you, Richie. Well, this pitch in pretty good shape here, but I think we're more likely to have some trouble with the weather here at the moment rather than the strip. There are some very nasty dark clouds looming not too far off in the distance. Now, the Bureau have in fact forecast rain for later on this afternoon, but I expect we're going to be seeing it sooner rather than later. Anyhow, let's take a look at the condition of this pitch. In pretty good nick, really, for a one-day game. It's quite flat, not much grass on it. Should be reasonably fast, but still the batsmen will be able to play their shots. Although you notice just over here in front of the popping crease, a couple of large cracks have opened up rather a long way. Now, I don't have the keys with me today. Richie's confiscated them. But you see here that they've come apart far enough for me to put my foot in there. Oh, gee. Better watch out, actually. Lost one of the old Julius Marlowe's last season doing this. But certainly these cracks are going to make this pitch a little bit unpredictable, and the batsmen will definitely have to be on their toes. Turning to our weather wall now, and what an impressive-looking piece of equipment it is. Very colourful and high-tech. But in point of fact, it's all bloody useless information that won't make a rat's arse of difference to the outcome of this match. The player comfort level, however, is of great importance in these matches. We've actually got a completely new system devised for calculating the player comfort level this summer. David Boone has been kind enough to come over and help us out. Thank you, David.
Yeah, you're welcome.
David's been warming up out here in the centre for a few minutes. Now, if you wouldn't mind just loosening your strides for me, David, so I can slip my hand down there and check the moisture content of that jock strap. And I can tell you it's very moist and sticky indeed down there. Absolutely saturated, really. Just look at how much moisture comes out when we give it a little squeeze.
Oh!
Yes, very humid, overcast conditions here, causing a fair bit of discomfort to some of these players before the day's out, I'd say. Just cough for me, will you, David? Yes, well, everything else seems to be in order. That's it from down here, Rich. Back to you now in the central mission, in the central commentary position.
Yes, thank you, Tony. Rather you than me. Any rate, it looks to be a reasonably good one-day strip out there. But as Tony said, the weather looks like it could be more of a contributing factor than the pitch here today. The toss of the coin, always of vital importance in these one-day matches. Here's Ian Chappell now with the two captains.
Oh, righto, AB. So what do you want? You want 100 bucks on heads?
Yeah.
OK, well, I'll have 100 on a tail. What about you, Jarvis?
I'll have 100 on a tail too.
Ian, you're on.
Oh, yes. Thanks, Rich. OK, Jarvis, if you'd like to do the honours, AB, you can call.
Heads.
And, yes, it's a fucking head.
Oh, you lucky prick.
All right, mate, what are you going to do?
We'll run this way, I think, Ian.
OK, well, Alan Border's elected to run with the wind towards the Paddington end, so that means Pakistan will have the kick-off. Good luck, fellas.
Good luck,
and back to you, Rich.
Thank you, Ian. Ian Chappell there with the two captains. Well, the players and umpires will be making their way out to the centre shortly, and we'll come back here to the SCG in just a few moments. Pakistan are going to kick off. What fucking game are we playing here? Has everyone gone completely mad? Who's batting, for heaven's sake?
I'm sorry to barge in, Mr. Benner. I'm afraid we've got another problem.
Fucking great. What is it now, security?
It appears Mr. Laurie and Mr. Gregg have barricaded themselves in the commentary box.
Oh, Struth, you have got to be joking.
No, Mr. Benner, I'm afraid not. Oh,
shit. I knew it was going to be one of those days as soon as I set foot in that bloody cab. I can't believe this. Hey! Hey, you two! What the bloody hell do you think you're doing?
We're going
first, Richie. Bullshit you are. Get out of that commentary box now, both of you.
No, I'm sorry, Rich, we can't. We've got Rich. We're the best openers on the team.
You won't be on the team for much longer. Now get out of there.
Control room to Richie. Control room to Richie. Can you hear me, Rich?
Yes, I can hear you, Jeff, but you better get down here fast, mate. We've got big trouble.
Why, what's the matter?
Just get down here, will you, Jeff? I'm outside the commentary box.
Righto, mate. I'll be down there in a sec.
You want me to shoot the door there, Mr. Benner?
That won't be necessary just yet, thanks, security.
Hey, Richie, what's the problem?
Ah, Jeff, are you ready for this? Bill and Tony have barricaded themselves in the commentary box.
They've what?
You heard me. Look at them. They're demanding they go first.
Shit. Well, they will have to go first now. Look, we're on air in about 30 seconds.
Ah, that's just great, isn't it?
Oh, well, listen, we'll have to try and sort it out during the ad break, Rich, but I've got to get back to the control room.
Yeah, okay, Jeff. You fellas are gone in there, you know that, don't you? You're dead meat. Security, keep an eye on them.
It's just not smart to go changing a winning partnership. That's what the fans want, Richie. It's a reliable waiting combination.
Gosh, shut up, Bill, you dickhead.
Well, stand by, Richie. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, cue him.
Welcome back to the SCG. Players and umpires are out there in the centre now. Alan Border won the toss and has sent Pakistan into bat. Wasim Ranamad Ruta, and what do you mean Wazi, are the opening batsmen out there for Pakistan. Bill Laurie is in the commentary box, and alongside him is Tony Gregg.
Yes, thank you, Richie, and welcome to our viewers on Nine's Wide World of Sports, wherever you are around Australia. Should be a good game, this. Both teams keen to try and build on their Benson and Hedges World Series Cup points tally. Good morning, Bull.
Good morning, Tony. Good morning, all. Tremendous day here today. Tremendous atmosphere around the ground. Good crowd in already. Both these teams desperately wanting victory here today. Trying to consolidate their position on the ladder and assure themselves of a place in the finals.
Yes, indeed, Bull. Pakistan, of course, the World Cup champions. After the Bastards narrowly beat South Africa last season.
Oh, come off it, Tony. They were thrashed. You're not going to crap on about that again, are you?
Well, Bull, as they say in South Africa, I don't want to be a bore, but I do think Pakistan were lucky to win that match.
Well, you're a wanker then, Tony.
But be that as it may, this match here today against the Aussies will be the only thing on Pakistan's mind at the moment, especially these two openers, Wasim Ranamad Ruta. And what do you mean, Wazi? And it's going to be Wazim on strike, and he's about to face the first ball of the day from Craig McDermott. Just as that one goes through the keeper.
Very important for Pakistan to get off to a good start here today, Tony. Wazim Ranamad Ruta probably holds the key here today for Pakistan. He's been in tremendous form this summer, hampered by a bad groin injury during the World Cup last season. Continued to play against doctor's orders. Finished up having to have a complete groin reconstruction and missed the tour to England.
Yes, well, he's certainly been playing well, Wazim, now that he's been able to put his groin behind him.
Yes, Tony. Apparently he's far more comfortable there. I understand it's the first time this type of operation's been performed. It's actually called a groin relocation.
Yes, Bill, well, it's certainly worked wonders for young Wazim Ranamad Ruta, who's really found some form so far on this tour. He's been scoring freely in some of these lead-up matches, had some great partnerships. Indeed, his batting average on this tour is quite remarkable. You see on his chart there, Wazim has an average of 193. He hasn't been dismissed so far on this tour, and certainly Pakistan would be looking to him to lead the charge for them here today.
Got him, yes, piss off, you're out. Beautiful piece of bowling, Craig McDermott. That's fucked his average, Tony. Wazim Ranamad Ruta on his way back to the pavilion for a duck on the third ball of the innings. The early breakthrough to Australia. And that's just the kind of start Alan Border would have been looking for. Pakistan in the very first over, a one for none.
Gee, that was a pretty good start for us, Bull. Had a little bit of the aggro thing going there.
Bloody oath, Tony. No one does it better than us.
Oh, gee, look at Richie out there, Bull, with his face pressed up against the glass. He looks really pissed off.
Well, of course he's pissed off, Tony, but a man's got to do what a man's got to do. Geez, don't go soft on me now. Look, we're doing the right thing, getting the call off to a good start.
We're the best openers in the team, not the Chappell brothers. You just can't go changing the teams willy-nilly.
Yeah, well, try telling Richie that. Look at him out there.
Hey.
He's fuming.
Hey!
Look, Bill, what's he saying?
Listen, you two. It's not too late to change your mind on this.
We can't, Richie.
No, Rich, we can't.
We have to keep going, Richie. It's what the fans want.
Don't give me that.
Crap, Bill, you bloody idiot.
It's crap, Richie.
It is crap, Bill, you stupid bastard.
Control room to Richie. Control room to Richie. Are you there, Rich?
Yeah, I'm here, Jeff.
Mate, what do you want to do about Bill and Tony?
Ah, fuck it, Jeff. Let them go. If they don't come out after 10 overs, I'll get security to break the bloody door down.
Yeah, righto, mate. Stand by, everyone, please. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2,
cue. Welcome back. Akib Matif and Ajar beside the bed at the crease now for Pakistan. He's replacing Wasim Ranamad Ruta, who was beaten all ends up by a magnificent Craig McDermott delivery.
Yes, Bull, this really was a brilliant piece of bowling by young McDermott. Nipped back quite sharply off the seam. Was even very slow to pick it up, and in the end, the ball has cut back a very long way indeed and hits round about middle and leg. Pakistan in a little bit of bother now, with Akib Matif in a jar beside the bed, ready to face a really fired-up Craig McDermott. Just plays that one away defensively on the onside.
This is a much better start from Craig McDermott here today, Tony. He bowled a lot of loose deliveries last week in Adelaide, especially early in his spell. He let a lot get away down the leg side. His line and lengths generally are pretty lackluster.
What was that again, Bull?
No, fuck off, Tony. I'm not going to fall for that one. You heard what I said. McDermott been right on the line here with his first few deliveries. Alan Board will be looking to him today for a better performance. And certainly at the moment, he's got his tail up with figures of one for none. As he moves in again now to Akib Matif and a jar beside the bed. It's about the big appeal. He's gone, is he? Piss off, you're out, is he? No, says umpire, strikes back. Oh, gee, that must have been very close indeed. Another brilliant piece of bowling from Craig McDermott. He's on fire here at the Sydney Cricket Ground. The whole place is abuzz. It's all happening for the big fast bowler. And the crowd really showing their appreciation for this magnificent opening spell from McDermott.
Yes, Bill, he really seems to have mastered the art of fast bowling in the last year and a half. Nothing McDermott does is ever half-hearted. Right from the start, he's always been his own very hard taskmaster, and it's marvellous to see all his hard work pay off. And here he comes again now to bowl to Akib Matif in a jar beside the ball. He plays that one out towards cover point. They're going for a single here. What do you mean? Was he going to have to hurry? The throw from Dean Jones hits the stumps, and was he run out without scoring?
Of course he was run out without scoring, Tony, you wanker.
Well, that's what I just said, Bill. Was he out, you stupid arsehole?
What do you mean, was he out, Tony? Look at the fucking replay.
I don't need to see the bloody replay, Bull. I've already said, was he out for a duck?
Oh, well, if you're still not sure, then watch the bloody replay, Tony. He was definitely out. 2 for 25 after 9 overs here at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Australia right on top here in these early overs. Wasim Ranamad Ruta and What Do You Mean, Was He? Both dismissed without scoring in the very first over. Akib Matif and Ajar beside the beds on 13. Char Vegemite for me and Dad is on 6, and there are 6 extras.
Yes, Bull, it's been a very hard slog for Pakistan so far in this match. And it's going to be Bruce Reid to take up the attack now from the Paddington end. He's coming in to bowl to Char Vegemite for me and Dad. Char Ved just pad that one away. Yes, Bull, Pakistan not able to take advantage of the field being up in these first 15 overs.
Oh, gee, look out, Tony. There's a streaker on the pitch. Oh, gee, some clown carrying a placard of some description.
Yes, Bull, well, we haven't had a streaker run onto the field for quite a while now. This idiot's come onto the ground carrying some kind of placard. Let's see if I can make out what it says. Give me my job back. Well, it's obviously some fella's had a few too many and thinks this is a good way to attract his boss's attention.
Oh, geez, it's bloody Max. It's Max Walker.
Well, what an unbelievable scene. Just look at this. Max Walker is streaking across the SCG. He's completely stark naked. Well, now I've seen everything.
Well, you certainly have, Tony. There's plenty to see, too. Just have a go at that thing, will you? Now, what do they call him, Tangles?
No wonder indeed, Bull. It looks like a baby's arm holding an apple. But finally, the police and ground staff security have caught up with Max Walker and are escorting him from the ground. Well, what an unbelievable incident this has been.
The crowd loving every minute of it. And look at this. A policeman is trying in vain to cover up Big Max's private parts with his hat.
He's wasting his time, I can tell you now, Tony. He's going to need one of those 10-gallon jobs.
Yes, indeed they will, Bull. But finally now it looks like they've got Big Max off the field. And play can now resume. It's going to be Big Bruce Reed coming in again to jaw Vegemite for me and Dan. And he smashes that one through the covers. The bastard's finally got onto one. Mark War is coming around, but he won't cut that one off. And into the fence it goes. And at last, Jarvet picks up a boundary for Pakistan.
Bruce Reed just straying down the leg side there. Not happy with himself. Spits in disgust.
Yes, Bull. Pretty handy spit it was too from Bruce Reed.
My word it was.
And this could be an appropriate time to remind our viewers about our Wide World of Sports Golden Golly competition to find the best spits of this season, 1992-93. It's a marvellous competition, this. We see some really spectacular gollies throughout the summer here as Reed moves in again now to jaw Vegemite for me and Dad. Just lets that one go through to the keeper. Now, we'll be showing the best gollies from time to time throughout this competition. And eventually we'll narrow them down to the final five. This is a replay here of Bruce Reed spitting just a moment ago. Not a bad one this either, Bull.
Well, he's always been a good gollier, Bruce Reed. Just look at this, right off the meat of the tongue. Good line and length, plenty of height on it from the tall man. There'll be a good chance in this golden golly competition.
My word, Bull, if he can continue this sort of form, he could be taking home that beautiful antique Wedgwood spittoon. Magnificent trophy, this. As Reed moves in again to bowl to Jarved. Just flicks that one off the pads to square leg. They'll pick up a single here. Now, just getting back to our golden golly competition. There's a viewer's prize, too, for the first correct entry opened in each state. And it's your very own golden golly. A piece of spit supplied by the player who wins this competition this year will be 24 carat gold plated. You see a sample of it on your screen there, and a very smart piece of jewellery it makes too. You can hang it around your neck or make it into a ring if you like. And one of these golden gollies going to the first correct entry opened in each state.
Well, that Wedgwood platoon will be the last thing on Bruce Rude's mind at the moment, Tony. Akib and Jarvet are both looking a little bit more confident in the last couple of overs. And Bruce Reed coming in now to Akib. He'll be very keen to pick up another wicket here. Bruce Reed slips and falls. Oh, he's hit the ground pretty hard. Oh, gee, he snapped in half, Tony. Oh, well, this is tragic. Bruce Reed has slipped over and snapped in half.
Well, what a disaster this is for young Bruce Reed and for Australia. Reed literally breaking in two after slipping over. We've been dreading something like this happening to the young man for years now. He's got that painfully thin physique. He's had numerous operations so far in his career. He really is built like a beanpole.
Well, it was just a matter of time, Tony, before something like this happened to Bruce Reed. He's got more nuts and bolts in him than a bloody hardware store, this young man. I don't think he'll be taking any further part in this match, Tony. They look like they're calling for the stretcher.
Yes, well, I think you'll find they're calling for two stretchers, in fact, Bull, to assist young Bruce Reed from the field. Although he seems to be showing a little bit of reluctance to leave the field, Bull. Yes, in fact, Bruce Reed is waving the stretchers away here. Yes, well, this is unbelievable, Bull. Bruce Reed appears to be calling for the sticky tape, is he? Yes, well, he's asking the Australian team doctor to tape him back together so he can play on. And that's just an indication of the marvellous spirit and determination in this Aussie team. Bruce Reed showing a ton of courage here.
Well, he might be showing a ton of courage, Tony, but he's showing he's got no fucking brains, if you ask me. You can't just tape yourself up after you've snapped in half and expect to keep bowling to the best of your ability.
Oh, blow it out your arse, Bull. You've got to give credit where it's due. And certainly that's what the SCG crowd is doing here. Huge cheers going up for Bruce Reed as he gets to his feet, making his way rather gingerly back to his mark for this last delivery of his over.
Well, I still think it's a ridiculous decision, Tony. The man's just snapped in half. It's a pretty serious injury. I reckon it's absolutely ludicrous to play on and run the risk of doing more damage.
Well, Bill, I think you'll find he knows what he's doing, Bruce Reed, as he comes in with the last ball of his over to keep a tee and a draw beside the bed. Oh, and that's a very good ball too from Bruce Reed. But oh, what's happened here? The sticky tape's come away, has it?
Of course it fucking has, Tony.
Well, this is a real blow. Reed bastard. Has snapped in half again. And oh, look out, the arm's come off too as well. And his head might have come away too, has it? Yes, well, Bruce Reed really gone to pieces now.
Yeah, he knows what he's doing, does he, Tony, you fucking wanker?
Well, this really is tragic for Reed.
Bullshit. It serves him right. I don't know who's more fucking stupid, Tony, you or him. It really was a silly decision by Reed to play on. Ludicrous. Ridiculous. Completely lacking in logic.
Well, you're a hard man, Bull Laurie. But I'm certain Bruce Reed will be taking no further part in this match. It's a big blow for the Aussies. But they're still very much on top here as drinks come onto the field. Pakistan are 2 for 30 after 10 overs.
Well, there you go, Tony. That's our 10 overs. I think we did bloody well.
Me too, Bull. Give me five. Give me five more. Down low.
Ah!
Too slow.
Shit.
You fall for that one every time, don't you, Bull?
Oh, you stupid prick, Tony. I think I broke my bloody finger again.
Yeah, sorry, Bull. Anyhow, I suppose we better go and face the music with Richie.
Yeah, I suppose so. Well, at least he can't say we didn't do a good job. I feel like we've performed brilliantly here this morning. Plenty of colour, tension, excitement. That's what the fans want. Must have a good, reliable opening combination to get the call off to a good start, and I think that's exactly what we've provided here today.
Yeah, yeah, Bull, save it for Richie. He's the one you should be telling. Well, here we go. We might as well get it over and done with.
Control room to Richie. Control room to Richie. You there, Rich?
Yeah, Jeff.
What's the story with Bill and Tony, mate? That's their 10 overs. Anything happening down there?
Yeah, stand by, Jeff.
I think they're coming out now, Mr. Benner.
I think they're coming out now.
All right, Blower, I'll freeze you away.
Hey, hey, calm down, security. Put that thing away. I'll handle this. Well, Bill, Tony, that was a very, very stupid thing you fellas just did there.
Yeah, but we did a good job, Richie, you must admit.
Don't start up with that bullshit again, Bill. Just shut up. Now, I'm not going to tolerate this sort of behaviour on my team. You fellas have shown a flagrant disregard for my authority, and I'm afraid I can't let that go unpunished. Now, I'll decide what I'm going to do with you both a bit later on, but meanwhile, you're both suspended from the rest of the call. You're out.
Oh, gee, Rich, I think that's a bit harsh.
I don't give a flying fuck if you think it's a bit harsh, Tony. Security, take him out.
With pleasure, Mr. Benno.
No, hang on. Not that sort of take him out, security. I mean, take him out of the broadcast area. Get him out of here.
Oh, right. Sorry, Mr. Benno. Okay, this way, please, gentlemen. Hey, Richie, I just want you to know, mate, I don't hold any grudges. To me, a grudge is nothing more than a place to park your car.
Strength. What else can go wrong today?
Control room to Richie. Control room to Richie. You there, Rich?
Yeah, Jeff, could you quickly come down for a sec? I'm going to be in the commentator's room.
Righto, mate, I'm coming down now.
All right, fellas, can I have your attention, please? Fellas!
Hey, uncool, man.
All right, now, after this little episode with Bill and Tony this morning, I've decided to elevate myself in the commentary order and go in at first drop.
Oh, that's best.
Now, I'm just trying to work out who I'm going to take in with me.
Why not take me with me?
Richie, take me with you, man. The Aussies love listening to me, man. That sounds so cool.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you might be right, Michael. Pat up.
Poor man.
Okay, Rich, what's the story, mate?
Decision, Richie.
Jeff. Listen, I've had to dismiss Bill and Tony. They're out.
It's fine with me, Rich. You're in charge.
Now, I've elevated myself in the order. I'm going in next, and I'm taking Michael in with me.
Yep, good idea. Now, Rich, there's one small problem, mate. Apparently, Max is on the loose again.
Ah, fucking great. How did that happen?
Well, security escorted him from the ground, but apparently he was seen a short while ago climbing back in over the fence.
Well, you better tell security to keep him out of the broadcast area.
Yeah, mate, I'll tell him. Now, listen, there's only about a minute to go, so I better get back up the control room.
Yeah, okay, Jeff, see you later on.
Excuse me, Richie.
Yeah, what is it, Ian?
That's a real disappointment for Greg and myself, not going in yet.
Yes, Richie, my brother's right. Certainly seems a bit unfair.
Look, I'm sorry, Greg. I know you and Chappelli must be disappointed, but you'll get your chance a bit later on.
Yeah, Rich, but we were supposed to go first. You said we could go first.
Ian, I have had a very trying day. Now, if one more thing goes wrong, I may just flip right out. So don't argue with me, please. Can you remember the golden rule we follow around here? We work as a team, and we do it my way. Okay?
It's okay, Richie.
Now, I want you all to keep practicing, keep your throats warm, and we'll see you in 10 overs. Okay, Michael, come on, let's go.
Richie, hang on, man. I just have another good look for my walk, man.
Yes, all right, Michael, but don't be too long, please.
Ah, what a shit of a day it's been.
Oh, well, can only get better. There's no need to lock the door, Michael.
Surprise, Richie. It's not Michael.
Max! What the hell do you think you're doing? You're not allowed in here.
Well, Richie, I've got this big motherfucker of a cricket bat here that says I am.
Oh, no. My nightmare.
Now, Richie, I just want a chance to prove myself. That's all I want. So play it cool and everything will be just fine.
Max, I can't let you call the game. Ah! Have a seat, Max.
Yeah, thanks, Ridge. Yes. Nice to be back in the old chair again.
Yeah, that's good, Max.
Control room to Richie. Everything right to go down there, Rich?
No. Ah! No worries, Jeff. Everything's fine, mate. We're revved up to the max.
That's good, Rich.
Jeff. We're ready to perform to our maximum capabilities.
That's great, Rich. All right, we're going to have a minute to go, everyone.
Jeff. You didn't say hi to Michael. Ah!
Hi, Michael. Everything okay, mate?
Yeah, g'day, Jeff. No worries. Everything's cool, bud.
Max!
Yeah, g'day, Jeff. How could you tell it was me?
Where the hell's Michael?
He's all right. He's outside, so we're listening to my Walkman. So Richie's asked me to sit in for a while as a guest commentator.
I did not. Ah! Did not think anyone would mind.
Well, not if it's okay with you, Rich.
No, it's not. Ah! Problem for me, Jeff.
All right, everyone, here we go. Stand by 30 seconds.
Well, Richie, I've been looking forward to this moment for a long time now. Don't fuck it up for me. Just play it cool and call your natural game and everything will be just fine.
Okay, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, cue him.
Welcome back to the SCG. 2 for 30, Pakistan, from 10 overs after Alan Border sent them into bat. Just starting to struggle a little bit here in the last few overs. Probably like to try and push that run rate along now, if they're to set Australia a reasonable sort of target here. Jarved Jamait for me and Dad, and Akib Matif and Ajab beside the bed. The two batsmen at the crease. Jarved has the strike. Ah! And joining me in the commentary box, it's a very good morning to Max Walker.
Yes, good morning, Richie. Good morning, everyone. Nice to be back in the old chair calling the game again.
Well, I wish I could say, how much we've all missed you, Max.
Well, thanks very much, Richie. It's really nice of you to say that. Been a long time.
And it's going to be Greg Matthews now to take up the attack from the Paddington end.
Yes, old smoking Mo Matthews, as they call him these days. They sent down a couple of the old offies to see if he could break up this pair. He comes down, left foot first, then the right. Left, right, wide left as the arm goes up and the ball leaves the fingers. Jar Vegemite for me and Dad comes forward and smashes that one through the covers. Oh, but a brilliant piece of fielding from Alan Border saves a certain boundary.
Super piece of fielding this from Alan Border, but it was a glorious stroke too from Jarved dancing down the pitch. Really clubbed it. He's only picked up 11 runs so far in his innings, but could so easily have been more than that. In fact, in the very first over Jarved faced, he had two balls cut off right on the fence.
Oh, gee, Richie, that could be pretty painful, I can tell you. Almost happened to me too earlier on today when I was jumping the fence on my way out to the centre. And nevertheless, Jarvin's been hitting it very solidly indeed, showing the bowler the full 4 1/4 inches of his blade.
Which you also did earlier today, Max.
Richie, I think you'll find she was a little more than 4 1/4.
Ah!
As Matthews again comes into bowl now, left foot first, followed by
the right.
Fuck's
sake, Max.
That familiar left-foot-right-foot combination as he lets it go. Jarvin flicks that one down to fine leg for a single.
Well, this could be trouble. Jarvid looking for two. He's turned blind.
Oh, gee, well, this is a tragedy. Jarvid can't see a thing. He's obviously got no idea where he's going as he tries to scramble back for a second, but he's not going to make it. Healy just flicks off the old bales, and Jarvid, Jarvid for me and Dad tragically run out for 12. After a freak accident of some sort. Did you see what happened to him, Richie? Did he get something in his eye?
No, I didn't see Max.
Well, he's certainly a plucky little customer, the Pakistan skipper, as he makes his way back to the pavilion without any assistance. His team's in a bit of trouble here at 3 for 31. OK, we're going to take you out to Royal Randwick Racecourse now for the feature event of the day, the Sirloin Stakes. Here's Kenny Callender.
What the fuck's Max doing there?
Hey, Kenny, you're off.
Yes, thanks, Maxie. Well, they're moving in quickly now for this race, the Sirloin Stakes, over 2,000 metres. So let's check the prices for you. The top weight, Show No Mercy, is at 6-1. Summer Sizzler is at 13-2. Senior Citizen and See So Shy at 7-1. Silver Sovereign from the TJ Smith Stables is 3-1 favourite. Southern Star is at 16s. Synchronise is at 6s. Sweet Surrender starting at 7-1. Although she should start a bit shorter with the bookies. Show Serious is at 33-1. Show 2 is Simple Solution. Street Smart is at 16-1. And Tappy, the old tongue, bleeding profusely at the moment, old son. Looks like another one of those bloody races where every fucking horse has got an S in his name. You might have to help me out, old son.
Yep, with pleasure, Kenneth, my boy. The last two are Slipstream and Sing a Song of Sixpence, and you owe me a beer, old son. OK, well, they're all boxed and ready. Starter's got the button. And they're off and racing. Sweet Surrender, one of the best to begin. Silver Sovereign also jumped out smartly ahead of So Serious and Synchronised. Street Smart settles in behind that bunch on the inside of Show No Mercy. Summer Sizzler a length further back to Southern Star on the outside of Senior Citizen. She's So Shy a length further back, half a length to Sing a Song of Sixpence. Slipstream is second last and Told Off last is Simple Solution. And as they settle into stride now, So Serious looms up on the outside to join Sweet Surrender in the lead. A length further back, Silver Sovereign on the outside of Synchronised. Show No Mercy, Southern Star. Further back is Summer Sizzler, followed by Senior Citizen. Two lengths further back to She's So Shy on the inside of Street Smart, and then a gap to Sing a Song of Sixpence. Slipstream is second last, and Simple Solution is back at the tail as they come to the 800 now. And the leader is So Serious, about to be tackled on the outside by Silver Sovereign, who's had the run of the race. A length further back to Sweet Surrender is grinding away, Synchronised in hot pursuit. About two away, Southern Star on the inside of Show No Mercy, who's having his ears scrubbed off. She's So Shy coming round the outside to make a line of three. Then a gap to Senior Citizen, Summer Sizzler. Fourth last is Street Smart on the inside of Simple.
SWAT Squad! Halt!
Control room to security, control room to security. Where the hell's that bloody SWAT Squad?
They're in position now, sir. The door appears to be pretty heavily secured, though.
I don't care. Shoot the bloody thing down if you have to. Just get Max Walker out of there.
All right, fellas. You heard the man. Let's go.
Now and Silver Sovereign still in front, a length to
Sweet
Surrender,
Sovereign.
Star and Silver Sovereign. On. So Serious has dropped back to be fifth on the inside of Senior Citizen, who's putting in a late run. Synchronizer's gone. Summer Sizzler is trying to get between horses. Street Smart and Simple Solution.
Jeez, what's all that bloody racket going on out there?
I don't know, Max.
Go, Silver Sovereign. Come on, Richard. Somebody kick this bastard home. Go, Silver Sovereign.
Just keep it down.
When you were trying to watch a bloody race.
Go, Silver Sovereign.
You little daddy, Silver Sovereign.
Jeez, what the hell's
going on here?
Mr. Walker, don't move.
Breath.
Are you okay, Mr. Bitter?
No, I'm not fucking okay, security. Oh. I've just been through a horrible ordeal.
Oh, right, sorry, Mr. Bitter.
Oh.
Hey, Richie, how was I? Pretty good, eh? I haven't lost it, have I?
Get him out of here, will you? Just get him out of here.
Right, Mr. Walker. Come on, come on, us.
Come on, Richie,
come
be
on.
Honest.
Come
how
quietly.
How good was I? Hey, hang on a sec.
Get him out of here.
Hey, how was I?
There he
me.
Hey, Richie. Richie, you okay?
Jeff. Sorry, Jeff.
It's okay,
I think
mate.
I'm about to snap.
It's okay, mate. It's all over now.
It's just been such an awful day for me.
I know, mate. I know it has.
Sorry, Jeff. I don't think I'm going to be able to go on. In all my years of broadcasting, I've never had to say this before, but I really don't think
Rich.
I can go on, Jeff.
No, it's okay, Rich. It's
I think
mate.
I'm going to have to go home.
That's okay. It's okay. It's been an ordeal for you, mate. I know.
I really am sorry, Jeff.
Richie, it's fine, mate. We can kick on without you. You just go home and rest. Now, come on. I'll walk you down and we'll put you in a cab. Just go home and rest. Come on. Let's get your stuff together.
Thanks, Jeff. I really am sorry about this.
It's okay, mate.
I just don't think I could get through the rest of the day.
It's okay, Rich. It's okay. Come on.
Are the Chapel brothers ready to go on?
Yes, Rich. They're ready, mate. Everything's fine. Come on.
Now, Jeff, make sure you tell the Chapels to keep it up, vibe, and keep it interesting, okay?
Okay, Rich.
No crapping on for hours with boring anecdotes or anything like that.
Righto, mate.
Now, you'll probably have to rotate the Chapels with Michael and David for the rest of the day.
Yeah, righto.
Because I don't want Bill and Tony back on the team today. They've been dismissed, okay, Jeff? They're out.
Fine, Rich. Whatever you say, mate. Taxi! Now, just go home, Rich. Put your feet up and relax, okay? Watch the rest of the game on TV.
Yeah. All right, Jeff. Thanks, mate.
Well done, mate. Oh, well, Jasper, what a bloody surprise. There are less like in my bloody cat. Plus, one, mate. What's the matter?
Fuck off. Yeah, car 343 just picked up at the SCG.
343.
Good. Now go away. You saw.
Three. And Bruce Reed has managed to pull himself together.
For fuck's sake, give me a break, will you? Where's the bloody FM button here?
Balance.
And giving you even more chances to win cash and a greater variety of cash. Keep listening, and when you hear your favourite song, be one of the first 100,000 people to call us and say, I want the cash, and you could win yourself $50 million in
Great.
Cold hard cash.
That's a lot of money.
Cash, and a chance to go back into the drawer to win one of three North Coast townships.
That's what I need.
So lock it in and stay tuned to win on the station with the cash.
Yeah, just give us a call when you hear your favourites throughout the day and you could be a winner and a radio programmer at the same time. And who knows, this could be your favourite. This is Maaarvellous.
Ah, great.
By the 12th Man featuring MCG Hammer.
Super song this.
Yo!
All right, I want everyone to move and groove and shake their funky things a little bit. You got my guitar there, Bill?
Got it, yes, here you are, Richie.
Okay, let's see what this little baby can do. Let's go! Ya-da-da. Ya-da-da.
You know, Richie, you really are a marvelous guitarist.
Yeah, you like that, do you, Tone? Yeah, dig that groove. Or the MCG, or the Gabba, or the Wacker, or the Adelaide Oval, or the SCG, it doesn't matter where we are down under in Australia this summer. Because when it's summer in Australia, if you don't like cricket, I can tell you it's a real bummer. That because cricket is the number one game in town.
Yo!
Just ask anyone around.
Yo!
Yo, boys, and from Bondi in the east across to Bunbury in the west, from Darwin to the Dandenongs, whatever your address might be, you can see me on the TV. Well, not just me, but the commentary team. They're sort of my boys, if you know what I mean. You know, I thought captaining Australia was a pretty tough job.
but I can tell you it's absolutely nothing compared to looking after this mob. Let me see, there's Bill and Tony.
Morning, Rich.
Morning, all.
And Greg and Ian.
Yes, morning, Rich.
And our guests, Michael H and David G.
Cool, man.
And of course, there's me, and we say, what a marvellous catch!
That's a marvellous shot!
They're a marvellous crowd, the Victorians.
Come on, fellas, let's kick it! We're the commentary team, and we call the game. It's marvellous! Yes, everything's marvellous! Because it's marvellous! Yes, it's M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S. That's right, it's M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S. Yes, indeed, it really is a marvellous effort, that. You know, every summer night when my head hits the pillow, I drift off to sleep and I dream about leather.
What?
And Willow Bill and Border and Bernie and Dino McDermott or Healy, whoever it might be, in this super Australian side for season 92-93.
What about Big Moon?
Yes, maybe.
He's a hero, this man.
Oh, come on, turn it up, Billy. Might be to you.
Well, he's got a lot of guts.
Well, he eats too much food. Hey, hey, you two. Now, it really doesn't matter. Look, no one gives a stuff if Big Moon's a little fatter. Just as long as we're thrashing those Pakis or Poms or Sri Lanka or the Windies, doesn't matter where they're from. It might be India, South Africa, Zimbabwe or New Zealand. But if I don't take a breath, I reckon I just might be keeling over soon. I'm trying to carry on and do my best.
Come on, Rich, you can't afford to take a rest.
Ah, stress.
Come on, Rich, we'll get you through it.
Ah, Jay.
We know it's hard, but you can do it.
Ah, thanks a lot, fellas. I think I'm okay. I'll live another day to say what a marvellous stroke.
And that's a marvellous knock.
What a marvellous throw.
That's a marvellous ball.
Come on, everybody, take your time. We're the commentary team and we reckon everything's marvellous. Yes, it's marvellous. That's right, it's marvellous. That's right, it's M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S. You heard me, M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S. Yes, indeed, it really is a marvellous effort, that. My name is Richie, and I'm the king. I'm the king commentator, I'm the number one thing. But I'm a singer, too, and I'm a jammer. And that's when I become MCG Hammer, and I feel a solo coming on, Bill.
Do it, Richie!
Yeah!
Give it to me hard and fast, Rich!
You got a turn!
I will play!
Magnificent solo effort, this is a guitar hero, this man.
What a marvellous match!
It's a marvellous pitch.
What a marvellous game.
Come on, I want to hear everybody. Let's really hop it up. We're the commentary team and we reckon everything's marvellous.
Everything's marvellous.
Marvellous.
Everything's marvellous.
Marvellous.
Everything's marvellous.
You know it's M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S. That's right, it's M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S. Background singers, keep it down a bit, please. Especially you, Snowy.
Marvellous.
Yeah.
Everything.
Dig it.
Marvellous. Everything's marvellous.
Yes, it's
M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S.
Spell it out. It's
M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S.
Hey, hey, back off a bit, Curly. This is our song. MCG Hammer, Bill.
Yeah, Richie.
Yeah, yourself. Spell it out. It's
M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S.
One more. It's
M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S.
Are you okay, Rich?
I think everything's okay, Tony. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yeah, it's marvellous.
Everything's marvellous.
Everything's
M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S.
I said it's
M-A-R-V-E-L-L-O-U-S.
Ooh, I didn't know.
Yes, it's marvellous.
Marvellous.
That's right, it's marvellous.
Everything's marvellous.
Everything's marvellous. Yes, it's M-A-R-V-E. Welcome back to the flat, love.
Ah, thanks, Pat. Maaarvellous to be joining you in the flat for the second time today.
Gee, you're home early. What, are you sick or something?
Don't ask, love.
You sounded a bit sick on the telly this morning with Max Walker. Oh, and that was very nice of you to give Max another go, Rich. Gee, he still sounds very good, doesn't he?
Oh!
Got him, yes, clean!
Check one, two, check one, two. Jeff, is my hair sticking out here?
No, Richie, it looks fine, mate. Stand by, everyone, 20 seconds.
Feels like it. Sticking up. How's the suntan? Am I brown enough?
Yeah, brown as a berry, Rich. Here we go, everyone.
Gee, well, I look a bit pale on this monitor.
No, the colour's a bit washed out on that monitor, Richie. You look great. Here we go, everyone. 5, 4.
Welcome back to the Adelaide Oval, and welcome to our viewers in England and India and New Zealand and right around the world who are joining us here for the first time today. And my word, it really has turned out to be a marvellous day for cricket here. Although at around about 9:45 this morning, a mass of thick black clouds was just hovering over this Adelaide Oval and really looked like it might threaten to disrupt the start of play in this very important World Series Cup fixture between England and Sri Lanka. And then fuck me if they didn't just disappear quicker than you could say, gee, it's going to piss down, and play got underway as scheduled right on 10 o'clock. Now, we can tell you that Alex Stewart won the toss here this morning and sent the Sri Lankans into bat. And they did pretty well, really, to be all out for 182. Not easy conditions for scoring runs here today. And we can also tell you that Mataya Muralitharan is not taking his place in the Sri Lankan side today. Mataya's a bit flat. Apparently he's been up most of the night chucking, and this morning Mataya very worn out. And they're resting him so that he might be all pumped up for tomorrow's game against Australia. Some pretty awful jokes there, but who gives a fuck? So the Sri Lankans sent into bat by Alex Stewart on a pitch that Tony Gregg described earlier on today as an absolute motherfucker. Now, we'll let you have a look at Tony's pitch report in a moment, but first of all, the Sri Lankan batting card. And they did reasonably well under the circumstances, Sri Lanka, all out for 182 off 49.2 overs. That's not too bad in these conditions, very hot and steamy here as the day's gone on. And you can see there that the opening pair for Sri Lanka, she wanted to pierce her ear, and I said, why not your vagina too? Both getting a start. Pierce her ear eventually dismissed for 28. I said, why not your vagina too? Played well for his 42 off only 55 balls. What a crummy singer, top scored with 60, and he played some glorious strokes in his innings. But then the collapse really came for Sri Lanka, as you can see there. Ramatunga down the throat of the skipper, out for 6. A card, a bunch of lavender, and Shavdeep Indervaz put on a handy 7th wicket partnership of 32. But neither of them able to go on with the job, and as you can see there, the tail end offering no resistance at all. In fact, the last two Sri Lankan batsmen dismissed with successive deliveries without adding to the total. Darren Goff claiming a feel like a chunder, and I might need a poo too, one after the other. So the Sri Lankans all out for 182. Now, just before we show you all the dismissals, I mentioned earlier the condition of this Adelaide Oval pitch here today. And for the benefit of our overseas viewers who've just joined us, or if you missed it earlier on, here's what Tony Gregg had to say this morning in his pitch report.
Well, Richie, I can tell you that it really does look to be a marvellous one-day strip here today. It really is a credit to the curator, Bob Geronkle, and his staff of groundsmen here. I tell you what, the last time I saw this many cracks in the one place was at last year's gay and lesbian Mardi Gras. Just look at some of these fucking beauties here in front of the popping crease at this cathedral end. Now, I'm not even going to bother putting the keys in there. You could park the car in these cracks. And they really are going to play havoc with some of these batsmen here today. And with some of these quicker bowlers like Mullally and Goff for England, or I feel like a chunder and I might need a poo too for Sri Lanka. Well, if they were to get the ball seaming off some of these cracks, we could see some real carnage here today. And I would not be surprised if someone has their fucking head knocked off. Anyhow, let's hope so. We'll take a look at our weather wall now, and you see there that the wind is coming from the northeast at a rather gusty 35 knots. Although coming more out of the south now as I speak, the temperature is a very warm 38 degrees. And the humidity a very sticky 82%. However, the Bureau have in fact forecast that there could be a chance of rain a bit later on. But at the moment, when you look at our player comfort meter here, well, I think you can expect that there'll be quite a few sweaty jock straps out there today. Probably lots of spots and pimples and rashes building up around the genitalia area of some of these players. So, all in all, stinking hot, strong wind, and the pitch an absolute motherfucker. Looks like we're in for a pretty good game here today, Richie. Back to you in the central missionary position.
Tony Gregg there with his pitch report from earlier this morning, and it was a combination of the condition of the strip and the fact that there might be a bit of rain around later on that would have influenced Alex Stewart's decision to send Sri Lanka into bat. And the Sri Lankan top order batsmen would have been shitting bricks this morning, I'd say, but in the end managing to put on 182. A pretty good effort, that. We're going to show you all the Sri Lankan dismissals now, and the first man to go was Shiwanda Piasaria. Was an absolute ball tear of a delivery, this, from Darren Goff. Piasaria beaten by sheer pace in the end, and umpire strikes back no hesitation at all in giving him out LBW. I said, why not your vagina too, was the next man to go. It's good to see him opening your vagina too. Hasn't opened for a while, and he played pretty well today for his 42. There was nothing fancy about it. Not many boundaries in his innings. He prefers to stroke your vagina too rather than swing his bat at it. And it was a sensible knock from him, but then Darren Goff produced a couple of very good balls that swung a bit, and eventually Goff taking out his middle stump, and that was the end of your vagina too. The next man to go was, dearie me, what a crummy singer, and it was a brilliant performance in the end from him. He had trouble getting into a groove earlier on, what a crummy singer. Seemed to be having problems with the pitch, but eventually found his rhythm, and dearie me, what a crummy singer top scored in the end with 60. Before Mark Elam really got one to swing, man. It was far out, I dug it. And dearie me, what a crummy singer. Going for the big hit, dancing down the pitch. Mistimed it completely and was clean bowled by Mark Elam. So it was a pretty good start there for the Sri Lankans under pressure in these difficult conditions. But then the middle order collapse started. When I hear Van Gogh was a painter and he cut off his fucking ear, both went very cheaply. And in quick succession, here Van Gogh is a painter, caught behind off Wells for just 3. And a few balls later, he cut off his fucking ear. Didn't hear the call from his skipper, ran my tongue down a throat, and eventually he took off, but he was always going to be struggling to make his ground. And in the end, fucking ear was nowhere fucking near it. Run out at the bowler's end for 2. The Sri Lankan skipper wasn't able to steady the ship either. In the very next over, Mark Elam had Ramatunga trapped plumb LBW for 6. And then came that 7th wicket stand between Akata Bunch of Lavender and Shavdam Indavaz. Akata Bunch of Lavender put on 16 runs before he was caught at mid-on by Holyoake off the bowling of Wells. And Shavdam Indavaz was dismissed a short time later trying to lift Robert Croft over the infield. He didn't quite time it and was caught at deep cover by Graham Thorpe. It was a marvellous effort that from Thorpe. He came all the way round from where he was fielding there in the slips to take that catch. And Sri Lanka really in some deep poop at this stage with the score at 8 for 179. I feel like a chunder and I might need a poo too. Never look comfortable out there. They were the next pair to come in for Sri Lanka, and with a fired up Darren Goff steaming in from the cathedral end, it was just a matter of time. And I feel like a chunder and I might need a poo too very quickly on the way back to the pavilion without adding to the Sri Lankan total. Like a chunder copped a brute of a ball. It flew off the pitch at an alarming speed. Like a chunder just trying to get the fuck out of the way there, and it came off his glove and went straight through to the keeper, Stewart. And Amadni Tapu too, just hanging the bat out to dry there, no footwork at all. A thick outside edge to Stewart, and Darren Goff brings the Sri Lankan innings to a close. The not-out batsman was an even crummier singer who didn't get to face a ball, and the final score, Sri Lanka, all out for 182. Well, the players and umpires not quite ready to come back out to the centre just yet. And just a few dark clouds starting to appear here at the Adelaide Oval. Not really looking too threatening, though, at the moment. And we should see both teams back out there in just a... Ah! Fuck me. Ah! Ah! What the fuck's...
We apologise for this breakdown in transmission. We seem to have lost our signal to the Adelaide Oval, but we hope to take you back to the cricket shortly. Ah! We apologise for this interruption to our apology. We hope...